The moon rose higher in the sky. A sentry watching over the whole horizon, scaring off any clouds from wanting to come out to play. The wind whistled down from the hills, rolling into the valley, sweeping over the trees, causing them to whisper and sigh in response. There was a moment of silence as it jumped off the treetops, like a child who'd made a ramp from some bricks and a piece of wood and was racing along on their bike to make the big leap. Suddenly, silently airborne for a split second, before crashing to the surface of the lake as the child crashed to the floor, both screaming as they landed. Ripples were whipped up on the water, disturbing the otherwise mirror-like surface, making water flow in a current where there had previously been none. At the edge of the trees, in that moment of silence, was a hollow, a fold in the ground, a shadow between shadows, between the tree roots, a nothing. It was as black, and as cold as the water lapping up to it. A place where everything was absorbed, light, sound, heat, hope, maybe even time itself. It was overgrown and unnoticed, somewhere you could be standing right next to and not know it was there. The tinkling of the wind chimes at Lake House was lifted by the swirling wind and taken up over the trees and back around the lake, jingling like festive sleigh bells. A last cloud dared to race across the sky, running from the disapproving gaze of the moon whilst joyfully chasing the sound of the chimes. They were carried across the lake to the far side, tossed around by the breeze, bouncing along the shore and sweeping into the silent place, into the shadows, the dark where no joy ever visited. The wind, whispering through the early autumn leaves, brought a chill to the air. The whispers grew louder as they dropped into the hollow, almost coalescing into words. Words that swirled and circled around the cold blackness, chanting, taunting, insisting, circling around and not taking no for an answer. Deep within the hollow, beneath the rotting layers of leaf mould and ancient tree roots, something stirred. The darkness moved like a blanket, raised from its slumber by the bells and whispers. The air moved, distorted, curving around the shape, the temperature dropping further, causing moisture in the air to freeze and form a frosty lip to the cave. The wind grew and clouds now gathered overhead, rolling in from nowhere like school children at lunchtime, ignoring the displeasure of the moon. The whisper swirled around and around, almost giving solid form to that which had risen, as it slowly emerged from the darkness into the dappled moonlight at the lake shore. The wind chimes tinkled their pretty refrain, vague and disjointed on the breeze, but a definite sound nonetheless. Then the whispers faded and died, disappearing on the breath of the wind like a sigh. The thing that remained shrieked, screaming a shrill noise from the water surface, then took to the air, rising above the trees, climbing vertically as the storm clouds covered the moon like a shroud. It rose and banked, turning towards the sound of the chimes, toward the house at the far end of the lake, toward Tichlin. And it flew like the wind.